G'day legends, welcome back to the channel. It's 12 months to the day that we've had the Africa Twin. So we're gonna head out today, go for a bit of a ride, check her out a little bit, have a chat, and give you my immediate thoughts on this beautiful beast of mine. And I thought we'd get out today at Wallaroo National Park. It's a nice day for it, it's pretty toasty. So we'll get out, go for a bit of a blast, have a chat about the bike, have a chat about how it's all looking and how I think, what I think about it, how much I love it, because you all know that I absolutely love this machine completely. So why don't we go for a bit of a blast up the dirt. There's a bit of a lookout up here apparently, and I've never been out here. So I thought we might go and have a quick look for that and go and have a bit of fun. Nothing too strenuous, just going to wander around today and get the feel again. So yeah, 12 months of the day, you know, we're driving down to, well, crikey, look at it, it's crap already. You know, driving down to Hawkesbury, getting out a little bit to go and check out the bike and pick it up. It's a long ride down to Windsor, but the team at Hawkesbury Motorcycles were just outstanding in helping me out with what I was looking for. And I was really, really happy with their service. The guys were great. It was a bit of a ripper of a day. The video's been pretty good, but so yeah, you could tell I was a little bit excited when I picked the bike up. Had never test ridden the Africa Twin. It was literally just go out, give it a shot, and see what you can, see what I thought the day I picked it up. And I was relying on a lot of people's opinions on the bike. There we go. That's not a road that we're going up. And how true and right they were. Because this beast of a machine has just been brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. But we'll talk more about that a little bit later on. We'll get out here into the bush, go and have a bit of a ride, have a bit of fun, and just get out on the dirt again. As you can see, just over 14,100 kilometers on the Twin. And she's been an absolute ripper to get out and have some fun on. Just totally love it. We'll start off at things like the electronics. The electronics, I'm a bit of a tech guy. I love technology. I love the way it works. And I thoroughly enjoy the way I've got my TFT with all the maps, so I can have Google. We can actually go in here and have a look. Here we go. So I've got Google Maps and Waze, Gaia GPS, which are also run off the phone. Then you've got all your other settings that, you know, messages, the phone, Spotify, music, but this is brilliant. Of course, going out to the other screen, we've got all these other modes, and I've chosen the gold mode for all of my riding modes because I love the information. I've got everything there that I need. If you go through these, we'll start right at the top. You know, it gives you 2 trip meters, your average consumption, your current consumption, or total liters that you've used. You know, a little bit, doubles up a little bit here and there, time elapsed, a B trip, which is handy for me for other stuff, just your usual stuff, voltage and range. And then you can move into your traction control, your wheelie control, the gravel button and ABS, and you can turn all of it off or turn it on. I mean, even today, you know, if we're gonna be going up some hills, you hold the enter button down. Where is it? There we go. And I can lower down the traction control. So, you know, put it down to 2. If you want to turn it off, you set it to 1 and then hold the left-hand button down here and that turns it off, and then you'll get your indicator up there and then you're back in again. So that works out pretty well. So we'll keep traction control off. However, when I start the bike up again, it will go back to the lowest level, which is level 1. So yeah, that's been awesome. And I have to admit, you know, the ABS, the traction control, wheelie control, it saved my bacon on a couple of occasions, without a doubt. So I love the way this works. I love the way the screen looks. Can really get in there and do all kinds of stuff. I'll keep my maps up and running so we can make our way out to this lookout. Yeah, the thing it didn't come with, which I wasn't overly impressed with, was a tire pressure monitor. There is another video about that, and I'll put the link up here, but this is the Psychic Rider. So this little device here, Bluetooth device, connects down to, and depending on where I've got my, there you go, connects down to these. They've got a locking lug and everything, so, you know, I was pretty happy with that. It's the only thing it didn't come with, bit of a gripe, but, you know, I'll get over that pretty quick. All right, let's look at the rest of the bike then. Hepco and Becca crash bars. These look like the Honda crash bars that you can get. They're aftermarket, of course, as well, but solid, solid crash bars here. And they've, they've paid themselves already. Wasn't too bad to fit if it wasn't for a mate of mine, Warren. He's the same guy that drove me down to Honda to go and check. Oh, look at that merch fly. Whoa, they hurt too. He's a guy that took me down to Honda to pick the bike up. We've been out in a couple of rides, and I get quite a lot of information off him, which is great. But yeah, we put those on. Took half a day or so, so that wasn't too bad. The DCT, oh my God, where do you want to start? When we talk about the DCT, seriously, what an amazing piece of kit that thing is. I was a bit dubious about it, but once you get onto it and get used to how it works and get used to the modes, I tell you what, you got three bikes in one. The different settings can completely change the bike and the way it feels, changes the gearing, and is comfortable. And for someone like me who's got no idea how to ride on gravel roads, sand, dirt, mud, whatever, I reckon the DCT is one of the big reasons why I haven't dropped it, touch wood, of course. So yeah, that DCT is just outstanding. If you're thinking about it and you just don't know, go and do it. Seriously, go and do it. They're a brilliant, brilliant piece of kit. Outback Moto Trek bars for the Lone Ranger Moto bags. These are easy to install through the standard plugs that they've got in here as well. The exhaust, I love the sound of this bike. It's outstanding. I wouldn't go past anything. I really don't have. And usually when I got a bike back in the day, the first thing I did was get rid of the exhaust. But I love the note on this. Absolutely adore and love that note. It is just beautiful. What else we got? Protection. Yeah, hand protection. The guards are okay. If I do drop it and crack those, I'll get some bark busters. But at the moment, there's no real need. And like I said, it's been 12 months and I've got away with it so far. So I'm pretty happy with that. That's been pretty good itself. A big fat tank. Let's talk about size, because size is everything. A lot of people have asked me, why the hell did you go and buy yourself a big bike when you've got no idea what you're doing in the adventure world? Well, how could you not? Look at it. It's beautiful. It stands out on the road. You're quite visible. I've got long range. I can get 550 Ks out of a tank, give or take some, depending on the riding. And that's what I was looking for. Most of my riding is on road. Most of the riding is going to be on the road there, on the bitumen, looking for the occasional dirt track like this. So I wanted range, I wanted comfort, wind and rain protection, which, I mean, look at that. Look, it does. It gives you everything. It's got the best protection ever. Legs don't get that wet on a heavy day. The screen, when that comes up, it covers me really well around the shoulders. This is brilliant. This baby is brilliant when it comes to size. Yes, it's heavy. So when you're out here on these kind of tracks, you've got to be a little more wary and a little bit more careful. And that's why I ride like a pansy. I do. You know, it's I do take it really easy. It's a $25,000 boner bike. I'm not just going to send it and hope for the best. I'm actually going to take my time, look after my pride and joy, but still take it out and do what I can with it to really enjoy it and get out and have some fun. So yeah, the size thing, yes, she's big. Yes, she's heavy at 250 odd kilos and fuel and bags, but that's exactly what I needed and that's exactly what I got. The other gripe, and Honda, you and I are going to have a bit of a Barney about this. My left fork seal started leaking at about 11,000 kilometers. I've dug some dirt out of it, got the debris out, but it's still got a bit of a slow leak. And it's not covered under warranty, and you advertise it as an adventure bike. An adventure bike should be covered under warranty. I mean, let's be honest here. It's there to go out and do some really crazy stuff, and that's how you advertise it. And if you're not going to cover it for the kind of gear that you're going to cover it for, well, you know, that sucks to be you, really. Well, it sucks to be the owner. We'll fix that later. We're looking at a full suspension revamp because the back is a little bit soft. Even though I've dialed it right up, it is a bit soft and a bit squishy in the corners on the road. We'll fix that at a later date. It's not a massive issue. It's not a big thing for me. But I like this. I like it. The size, the agility of it when I need it, the road feel, the whole lot. It's just a beautiful bike. All right. Why don't we get out and about? We'll go for a bit of a hoot. Keep riding. See if we can find this lookout, because I'm not having much luck at this stage trying to find it. That's for sure. Like I said, it's a big bike. It's taken me, you know, a good solid 12 months and the patience of a lot of people to help me into adventure riding. Still haven't done a course yet, which I've got to have a look at some stage or another. That will be one day. All right, where's this leading us now? This is not one of the nicest state parks around. A lot of people dump their stuff here, which is really unfortunate because it could be a beautiful, beautiful area, but unfortunately it just isn't. I want to stay off any of these tracks though, because they get really dodgy and I've got no intention of going down something like that. Let's see how the Insta goes through all of this as well. If you're keen on one of these cameras, check out the links below. I've loved these two cameras. They've been absolutely brilliant. GoPro's been failing me way too much, so I had to move it around a little bit and make a decision on something else. Glad I did. Whoa, that's a big puddle. Okay. All right, you know what we're gonna have to do. I won't lie, the Africa Twin does give you quite a lot of confidence. Being so new into this, I was a bit hesitant about doing some of the off-road stuff, but as time went on, geez, the confidence really did grow, and I've had a lot of fun. Had some close calls as well, but had a lot of fun mucking around on this thing. Oh, that looks green. Oh, it's cool. Far out. Oh. Yeah, I can't get over how much water is still out here at the moment. It's pretty insane. Oh, is this the quarry? How about that? Bit of a unique spot in itself, isn't it? Cool. Big, big play quarry. You see where the off-roaders come out here and checked it all out. And it's a bit unique, isn't it? I have no idea where this will go though. No idea at all. If you've seen Biker Bits, Mark, this looks like your little playground, mate. That looks pretty unique, pretty interesting. Okay. Do love this part of the world. It's good. It's very good. All right. Oh, look at us sitting in the sun there. How gorgeous is that? Let's see if I fall on my ass. Oh. Yeah, it's cool. Oh, look at you. I love this bike. Now, a lot of people have had issues with the startup and how long it takes and everything. I haven't found a problem with that. I've taken off where I've just kicked it up and it's gone straight into its, you know, its little startup mode. I'm just gonna change to S1. Yeah, you know, it does that. It takes a while, but it's not life-changing, that's for sure. lights around here to go and have a look. Yeah, it's not life-changing, it's not a big thing. I don't have any issues with it. Oh wow, look at this. You can see people have come out and had a pretty good time out here. If I had a four-wheel drive, I'd be coming out here for sure. Just got to remember which way we're going now. That can't be the road, is it? Must be, all right. It's a gnarly track, isn't it? Oh yeah, here it is, joining up. Cool, cool. Awesome. Let's see if we can get out to the main road and have a look. So yeah, the startup's not really a big issue, you know. You can wait for it if you want, or you can just bypass it, jump on and keep riding and then hit enter when the button says so. It's not a big thing. Now I have found sometimes as well that the button doesn't like to work, so there's been a loose connector there. The guys at Honda can't really find it, so not a huge thing. Would have been nice to get it fixed, but every now and then you've just got to have a fiddle with the connections and get that sorted out. Again, it's not something on an adventure bike that this should happen, but it does. And I don't know if any other riders have had the same issue, but yeah, it kind of gives you the shits a bit. People's junk everywhere. It's horrible, isn't it? Well, that doesn't look nice. Let's go and have a quick look at this. I don't know if we're going to be able to get over that. All right, go and have a quick look while we're here, because that looks pretty full on. Yeah, so there's some little things that I think Honda should sort out, but again, they're little things that you can kind of sort out yourself anyway. So you just got to muck around with it, I suppose. But look, I have zero regrets. The Africa Twin is certainly one of the best bikes I've ever ridden. It's a hell of a lot of fun. Oh, I could take that, or I could take that. That's good. Love it. Yeah, she's a hell of a lot of fun. She looks great. Very, very practical. If you want to just road tour on this, you can do that very easily. It's, I think it's one of the best all-round bikes. Now, I love the GS. My 2013 GS was great, and I did consider a 1250 or 1250 GSA. It's hot. You know how hot it is at the moment? 26? Yeah. 35, that's better. Look at that, 35 degrees C, and I'm wearing all this. I got a trick to it though, with my Kamina gear. I got something I got to show you, but I'll do that in a little while. Yeah, great road touring. That screen is epic. I didn't like the screen on the 22 model. Just wasn't overly keen on it. The 2020 model, but the 22 model, this one here, it looks better, and I think it's designed a bit better. It certainly does a great job deflecting that wind and the rain. It saved the Insta360 a couple of times with debris being flung off the set itself. So yeah, I've been pretty happy with that. Whew. What a day indeed. So, you know, I can come out now, 12 months later. I wouldn't have done this 12 months ago on mine. I can come out here quite confidently. You see, I'm still going slow. Like I said, I'm the guy with all the gear and no idea. It's a great spot. Now, this is another bit of a gripe with Android Auto. I don't know what it's like with Apple CarPlay, but occasionally you lose connection and it comes down to the cable. So I'm using a Rode wireless, the microphone charge cable. So you'll pull it out again, stick it back in there and let it come together again. I'm not in off mode. That was a bit silly, wasn't it? That's probably why it's feeling a little bit more different. There we are. Oh, but that's that's one of my markers. This is one of the spots that I've been wanting to come out and have a look at. So yeah, look, this has been pretty good. Why don't we park it up? Have a look around here, park it up in the shade, and go from there. Sounds like a good idea. All right. Oh, the other pro to this, and I'm glad I've got it. That bloody center stand is a lifesaver. All right, so that's it. That's my thoughts on the Honda Africa Twin. A beautiful big bike with 12 months to the day. The big girl and I have had a hell of a lot of fun together in this time. And I mean, that's, yeah, I love it. She's gorgeous. She looks good. She performs well. Confidence inspiring. Capable. She's brilliant. And then where we go from here in 2023, who knows? We're just going to go out and have a hell of a lot of fun. I love it. It's so good. It's so good. So look, that's my general thoughts on the Africa Twin. We've had this big girl now for 12 months. I'm loving it. She's going to stick around for a very long time to come. If you like this kind of stuff, give us a thumbs up. It helps the video. Subscribe to the channel. And keep an eye out for the other videos. I'll talk about some of the other gear that I've got. All right. It's a nice place to sit back and chill out. I might just do that. All right, aru for now.